Hi guys, I am Katie Johnson. I'm a member here at Ascension Lutheran, and I am a college student up at the University of Northern Colorado in Greeley, and I'm here to share the story of how Solomon builds the temple. David was a great king for God's people. God told David that his son Solomon would build a temple. When Solomon became the king, he wanted to build a temple so God could live there. He wanted the temple to be the most dazzling, amazing building ever built. Solomon decided he would build the temple out of beautiful and expensive materials. First, Solomon told his workers to dig large stones out of the ground. "I don't want God to hear any loud building noises here," Solomon told the workers. "You need to measure, cut, and shape the stones in the hills before you bring them here." The workers did what Solomon told them to do. Next, Solomon told his workers to make the roof and floor out of a hard, sturdy wood called cedar. "Carve designs of flowers into the cedar wood and decorate the temple with the carvings," Solomon directed. "The nice smell and elegant designs will make God happy." The workers did what Solomon told them to do. Finally, Solomon made a room especially for God. "Cover the entire room in gold," he said. The workers did what Solomon told them to do. The room glowed and shimmered. When the temple was finished, Solomon put a special box called the Ark of the Covenant into the room of gold. The people had put God's Ten Commandments in that box. Wherever the Ark of the Covenant was, God was there too. The people went to the temple every day to worship God. The temple was the most impressive building ever built for God, and God was happy to live in the temple Solomon built. When Solomon finished building the temple, the people went and worshiped there every day. When I think of worshiping, I think of coming to church or just being by myself, because no matter where I am, God is with me. And no matter where you are, you can worship God wherever, whether it's at church or at home online, but God is with you no matter where you are, and you can worship Him wherever. Dear Lord, thank you for today, and thank you for our families. We are grateful that you are with us and that we can praise you wherever we are. Amen.